Hey guys, so in this episode of React Redux series, we're gonna look at a special middleware called Redux-thunk. In the last tutorial, we built our own little middleware, but obviously you don't wanna go about building your own middleware, so you should be using the one that is already available. So there are multiple options. There's also Redux Saga, and there are a couple of other options also available, but these two are pretty famous. So today we're gonna look at Redux-thunk. And in subsequent tutorials, we might look at Redux Saga. This video is part of the much larger series on React. So if you're not following it, I would highly suggest you should do that. I'll provide a link here. And welcome to Techsy Tutorials. All right, so before we start, let's try to understand what is the meaning of Redux thunk, especially the word thunk. Somebody explained to me that thunk means past tense of think. I don't know if it's true or not, but in JavaScript world, thunk means if you're gonna execute something, a statement, instead of just executing right there, wrap it with a function. And so you have to call the function to execute, which returns that statement. And so that's how you execute it. And so that's what it means. And in this case, remember we have dispatch actions. So instead of dispatching action right there, we're gonna wrap it with a function, a thunk, and then we're gonna call that function to return those actions. And that's how it's gonna work. All right, to start with, I'm going to use one of the example that I used in a previous tutorial. If you wanna download it, you can do so. And I also provide it in the description so you can download it and clone this. And again, when I run this example, I have two buttons, action, age up and age down, which changes the label. It increments this by one when I click on up and decrements by one when I click down. And if I look at the code, it has app.js, has two buttons and a label. And I have two actions, age up and age down. And then I have a reducer where it takes that action and increments it based on the action. And the state is pretty simple. Just one property called age. Okay, so let's modify this to build our middleware using Redux-thunk. So as I said before, thunk is nothing but you take the action and instead of executing it right away, you just wrap it with a function. Okay, so that's what we're gonna do. Inside the app.js, I have this two action, which is nothing but just object that it dispatches, right? So instead of just dispatching those objects, I am going to wrap around this with a function. So in order to create it, we need to name it action creator because that's what it actually doing. It creating actions, right? So in the store, I am going to create a folder called actions, and the reducer, I'm also going to create another folder called reducers. And I'm just gonna put the reducer inside there. And inside the actions, I'm going to create a file called actions.js. And this is where we're gonna write our action creators. All right, so let's write our first action. We will look at the thunk in a minute, but first we need to convert this into action, all the action to action creator. All right, so I'm just gonna copy this age up from here. And inside the action.js, I'm going to create a function, const age up equal to, it's an arrow function that returns that object. So I'm just gonna put it here. And for the value here, one, I can pass that value here. And so this would be val. So this is our age up action creator, basically. Because it, when I run this, it would return this object, which we can use inside the app.js. All right, since we created it, we need to also export it. And similarly, I can copy this and here, and this would be age down. And here, this will be down. So now inside the app.js, instead of using this action, we're gonna use the action creator to create this action. So we need to import that action creator. So I'm going to say import action creator from store actions. And instead of dispatching this, I'm going to say action creator dot age up. And I'm going to execute this function and provide one here. Same thing for this action creator dot age down and pass one here. But here, instead of this, I have to say everything as action creator. So now it's time to install Redux-thunk. So from the command line, I'm going to say npm install dash dash save Redux-thunk. Okay, now that it's installed, let's make sure that it's inside the package.json. I would have the Redux-thunk here. All right, that's great. Now, where should we install this? So it has to happen inside the index.js file. So here, I would have to import thunk from Redux-thunk. And I also need, from Redux, I need to have apply middleware. So we can apply the middleware to this project. And inside the create store, with the reducer argument, we also need to pass another argument where we execute this function, apply middleware, and pass thunk inside. So that's all you need to do in terms of Redux-thunk. Basically, import thunk, import apply middleware, and then pass this argument here, and that should plug it in. All right, so I'm just gonna run the npm start to make sure everything works fine. All right, so everything still works fine. I can click on this button. See, all we did here is just move, instead of actions, we created action creator, and via that, we are now calling action, but we haven't done anything asynchronous. So let's try to do that now. So what I'm gonna do is, I have two actions here, age up and age down. So age up, I wanna make it asynchronous, but age down, I wanna keep it synchronous so I can see the difference. So I'm going to call this async. I'm not going to call this directly. I'm just going to still have to call a synchronous event. So for that, I would have to create another one, call age up, which will have the value as previous one. Inside, once it captures the action, it would return another function which will have dispatch. Again, all of this is taken care of by the Redux-thunk, so you don't have to worry about it. You just need to make sure that when you do something asynchronous, this is the pattern you follow. So here, when I call the age up, it will dispatch, it will return another function, and here we can capture our action and do something with it. So what I'm gonna do, in order to do something asynchronous, I'm just gonna use a set timeout. And set timeout, as we know, has a function inside that runs when you run the set timeout, and then it would have some delay, runs after a certain second. So in this case, it's 5,000 milliseconds, which means 5 seconds. And what I'm gonna do is, now I'm gonna call this age up, async function from here. So I already have the dispatch. So I capture the action and I'm going to dispatch this age async function. Oh, I also need to call this function. Now if I run this, when I click on this button, it's not gonna run right away. It's gonna run after 5 seconds. So basically what happens, the action get dispatched, and then it gets caught by this age up function, which catches the action, and after 5 seconds, dispatches another action, which actually reaches the reducer, which is this, okay? So when I click here, it should run after 5 seconds. So 1 1000, 2 1000, 3 1000, 4 1000, 5 1000. Yeah, around 5 seconds, right? So you can see it increase. Now it would be nice if I can see if I when I click here, I need to have some loading logo or something. So think of this as if I'm saving this value onto the server, and when it comes back, either it could be successful or a failure, right? So if it's a successful, I would go and save this continuous action to the reducer. If it fails, then I should just stop it here so it never reaches the reducer, and so it never updates the state, right? And it could do something else also. All right, so when you create this project, there is a logo.svg which is comes with the whole package. So I'm gonna use that. So if I go to my app.js, here I'm gonna add another property in the state called loading. And this should be state.loading. And this loading we need to trigger when I click on the age up button. And once it reaches the reducer, it should take it off. Where basically it should hide the loading, right? So here, what I need to do is props.loading. That's true, then conditionally render the logo, which is nothing but image and source equal to logo. And the class name equal to app logo. All right, so but we need to import this logo here. So we would say import logo from logo.svg, which is nothing but this. And it's basically SVG of the React logo. I need to create another action on the top here. I'm gonna call it export const loading. This would basically return type is loading, and we haven't created this action yet. So in the reducer we can add another case called loading, and this would do nothing but new state dot loading equal to true. All right, so when I click on it, it would basically show the logo. And now I need to call the action. So that would happen, since it's we wanna keep it as a synchronous action, I can actually call it here. So one action I'm calling age up async, but here also I can call dispatch and loading. All right, so this is a synchronous and this is asynchronous. All right, so let's look at it, how it works. So if I click on here, it actually loads it, but there is an issue. Oh yeah, the source supposed to be the interpolated, not the string. Otherwise it would not show up. So now if I click on here, it shows a logo, but it doesn't go after 5 seconds. So we need to take it away after 5 seconds when it reaches the reducer. So in the reducer, so we already know when it reaches the reducer, we should just take it off, right? So when I click on the age up event, and when it reaches the reducer, it should simply just makes a new state dot loading equal to false. Right, so now if I click on here, it shows up, and as soon as this increments to 21, it goes away. And also the cool thing about this is when I catch the action and dispatch it again after the timeout, I can actually change its value. So I can say well plus plus, and it would, instead of incrementing by 1, it would increment by 2. Just to show you, I mean, it doesn't make sense in this case, but just to show you how it works. So now if it's 20 here, if I click on here, the logo shows up, and then it would, instead of one, it would increment by two, so it becomes 22. Okay. So you can change the action here. Okay, so that's all, folks. But in the next tutorial, we will, instead of using the simple set timeout, we will do actually interaction with server. So where we try to save something on a server, and then so basically try to do get and post. So we're going to look at a little bit more practical example than this simple example. But I think it's important to understand this using a simple example so you get the concept, and then you move on to a little bit complex example. And by the way, feel free to follow the entire series. I provide a link here. And I hope you learned something from this tutorial. And if you did, please like. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And you can also help the channel via Patreon. I'll provide a link here. And also, you can translate this video for me if you can to your native language. It's pretty simple. The instruction is in the description. Thank you.